Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over how to make a reusable blueprint door. So let's get started. The first thing that we need to do is get the door ready and get it all set up to blueprint. So I'm going to just use the prop door and I'm going to select the door frame. We'll use that as a starting point. So I can simply right-click on that and say create a blueprint using this. And I'll put it in the blueprints folder. I'll use the BP naming convention. And we don't want it to be door frame. Give it my initials. So there we go. One thing to note, now that it's built that, it's got a, this is the static mesh. Let's hit F2 to rename it. The first node that you put into a blueprint won't have a transform on it, which is one of the reasons why I didn't put the door into it. And there's different ways of getting around that, but for now we're just using the door frame. So let's select the static mesh door. We'll go in and we'll say mesh, and we'll choose static mesh. So now we've dropped in a door. We'll name this my door, and we'll hit F to frame that door up and nudge that into place. As we nudge it into place, I set my snapping to 5. You may need to do that if you are following along. The default is set to 10. So we've got that set. Now we need to detect something that will let us know if we're near the door. That's the logic I'm following. So I'm going to use a box collider. So box collision, and let's just scale that up to a point that will be useful, somewhere close to where we're standing near the door. Good enough. Okay, so now that we've got that set up, we could probably make it a little smaller, but it's good. So now that we've got this box collision set up, my door, we've got all sorts of. Let's go back into the event graph. And now we're in the event graph, and we've got. I'm going to delete the default things in there. I'm going to select the box collision. And I'm going to right click and say add event for box collision. I'm going to say add component on begin overlap and on component end overlap. So now that we've got that set, what are we detecting? Well, we're detecting if we're near that door or not near the door. And it seems like a Boolean to me. So let's create a Boolean called near door. And so I'm going to hold down the Alt key to create a setting function. We can Control C, Control V to duplicate that. If we are near the door, I'm going to set that to be true. So when we overlap, and if we're not near the door, we'll set that to false. By default, that's already set. Let's comment this. Near door detection. Okay. So now let's create the next step, which would be making the door work. So let's select the door and we'll hold down the control key and drag an instance variable of that. And we've got we will set up a rotator. So now we're making that rotation. And we are going to set a relative rotation to that door. So we're going to make the door rotate, and it's going to be rotation. And we will say set relative rotation of that door. If we did add relative rotation, the door would spin like crazy. So we don't want that. We just want the relative rotation. So how are we going to control the relative rotation? Well, with a timeline. And so we've got this is the door amount rotation, and we need to create some data in here. Well, let's create a float variable. We'll call this door rotation amount. And let's set some keyframes. I'm holding the shift key down. And within 2 seconds, we'll have that door open up 160 degrees. It's a lot, but should be fine, and we'll say the max length is 2 seconds. We could also make the door ease open a little bit which will look a little bit better. So if by right-clicking on these, we're setting an ease-in interpolation. Okay, so we should be good. Let's connect this store rotation amount to the yaw and the update. And now what we're going to do is set up so that when we are inside, when we call this, we detect, so pretty much we need to detect if we're near the door and are not near the door. So that sounds like we're going to be using this near door variable. And by doing that, we're going to use a branch. And then I'm going to hold control down and set our near door variable that we've set up here. So it says, okay, if we're near the door, do something. If we're not near the door, don't do anything. So, and if we are near the door, we're going to flip-flop. I could just make the door open or just close, but I want it so that every time you hit the, we'll set it to the E key, that the door either starts to open or it starts to close. Okay, and then the final step is we want this to be reusable multiple times. And so one way of doing that is to make a custom event. So I'm going to make a custom event and we'll call this door, my door open. Okay, and so now I connected that all up. I'm going to hit a comment, door open sequence, and let's compile. And we'll go into the level blueprint. So now that we're in the level blueprint, how do we call that door? And so, well, we're going to make it so that I said we'll make E key the door trigger. And then when we hit the E key, we'll say get all actors of class. So we're calling the blueprint class. What was the name of the class? It was like my door, door, BP door SF. That was the name of the blueprint that we created. And now, once we've got that called, we want to cycle through all the potential doors in the level. And so that would be a for each loop. And then we need to connect that. And then once we have this for each, within each door blueprint, we're going to call the custom event. And so when we drag a line from here, we have access to all the variables inside of that blueprint. So what I'm going to be looking for is the my get my door. Let's see, actually, I don't want to call just the variable. I want to call the custom event, which is the my door open. So my door open. There it is, my door open function. Great. So let's comment that. And let's, we could even set up a, if we wanted to, we could have it tell us within the door sequence if we were not near a door. So we could print the string. Not near door. Okay. So, and we can take a look at what that does. So now that we've got that all set up, let's bring door two into the scene, or three. Okay, we brought a door in. I'm going to rotate that 90 degrees. We'll get that at least close and nudge that into place. Okay, good enough. We'll hold down the Alt key to duplicate that. And we'll do one more for the third door. Hold down the Alt key. We can also hold down Alt and we can hold down the Shift key now to take our camera with us so we get it into place a lot faster. So now we've got three doors. Another thing for prototyping purposes, I often will like to go in and set the collision area to some sort of visible format. So we can go back into the rendering and say by default it's hidden in the game, but for testing purposes, we're going to make that not hidden. So let's test this out. Play. And we'll get close. I hit E. And you can see there's not near door hit three times. But when I get close, I hit E. Okay, this door opens, and I get two not near doors. So that tells me I have three instances of the door in my level, and one door opened. So let's test the flip-flop to make sure that's working. So I hit E again, it closes. I can hit E, I can catch it midstream. Great. So that pretty much sums it up. Let's just summarize. I'm going to hit escape. I created a door. I created a door frame. Then I brought in the door and a box collider. We went into the event graph. We created a one variable only, a Boolean, that says near the door. And we detected if we were within the box collision. And we set the Boolean. Then we created a branch and said if we are near, so if this is true, then evaluate the rest. And that's a little bit, that creates a little bit of an efficiency. And then we set a door rotation amount from 0 to 160. We went through, we made it rotate, and we set the relative rotation. And then we created a custom event. And we accessed that custom event from the level blueprint. All right. Awesome. Thanks so much for watching. Have a good one.